Didn't you also publish a few years ago, you had a very small pilot trial where you showed patients with Parkinson's disease early diagnosed, I think they were medication-free even, and you had them doing this sort of moderate to intense, high-intensity treadmill exercise, and it seemed to change the way, the sensitivity of their brain to dopamine, or to some receptors, dopamine receptors.
Exactly, yes.
So, like, they're basically using it better, you know, the little they have, it's better at it, you know.
Right, more efficient, yes.
Right.
So that was another thing that we had seen, which is actually changes in dopamine receptors, right? So the idea was that we had taken patients who had not been on anything and essentially no meds anyway, and you know, were really recently diagnosed, and then putting them on a treadmill. And I would argue that although the treadmill, again, so intensity in two ways, one, obviously getting their heart rate up, but they were actually also getting a lot of feedback on gait and balance, again, constantly correcting, going up on speed, so they had to become more
accurate.
So having
like a personal trainer seemed
completely
to kind of be very important.
Yeah, they were getting tons of feedback, and by going up on speeds, now you're having to work harder to make sure you're accurate, so again, you're in the zone, if you will. But in any event, yeah, so we were able to show that we saw changes in dopamine receptor levels, with the idea being that the amount of dopamine you have with a better receptor expression, you're becoming more efficient. And that was duplicating what we saw in the animal model. Right. So this was kind of nice to be able to show it in both a rodent model and translate it to humans.
It goes along with the adaptations you were just talking
about
as well.
Absolutely.